morning is being performed by Mr. Aiden Carter. Now I would like to introduce Doreen Forrester, the principal at Visions Unlimited. Please be seated. Thank you so much for coming today. We so appreciate your support, and we so appreciate having our graduates here to celebrate in person. We're so happy with the growth they have made. We're honored that we can support them. I'd like to say a few words about each of our graduates before we get underway. Miss Gabriella Gabby Cruz. Gabby is an individual who absolutely loves to work in the shop. She enjoys making paper, she's an expert at running a switch, and she enjoys helping her classmates. She loves all things Ghostbusters and all things Christmas. Miss Ashley Grabrinsky. Ashley is one of the nicest, friendliest individuals we have. She's an excellent greeter at Visions and makes everyone feel welcome. Most importantly, Ashley has increased her independent skills this year. She is one of our success stories in using the Smart Flex Bus to independently provide transportation for herself. Jonathan Horton. Jonathan, I spoke to your classmates on what they would say to you as an honored student of Visions. And one of the things they said most about you is that they can always depend on you to cheer people up when they are very upset. You're a compassionate young man who always is willing to help his friends and classmates. You're also an excellent listener, and you're very creative. And I know best of all that you are one of the most excellent artists Visions has ever had attend the school. We have your artwork everywhere at Visions, and we're so appreciative of it. Bryce Kopp, you are one of the most inquisitive and an individual who can figure everything out. You are also one of the most determined young men I've ever met. Bryce also likes to leave me lists around the building so that I know exactly what I need to do at Visions, what classes I need to add, and what changes I need to leave to the building. He's one of the most self-expressive students we have at Visions. Passionate persons of Visions. You absolutely make the ASD classroom smile when you go down to help and volunteer. You brighten their day. And one of the most great things about Jake is that every time I come into a classroom, he leads the room in a round of applause for me. Michael Monick. Michael loves to smile. He smiles at everyone. He's the most welcoming individual. He's an excellent river cutter for the shop, and when we need production done quickly, Michael is the one we go to. Michael also loves all forms of music, and most importantly, cardio drumming is one of his favorite classes. He does cardio drumming with such enthusiasm that I go to the class just because I know I will burn calories standing next to him. Is our student council president at Visions. He's a great friend to many people at Visions. He likes music and he loves his dog, Cody. I will always remember Wuju for being the best predictor of school snow days that we've had at Visions. We used to look forward to his messages being posted on the cafeteria board, letting us know when we would have a day off of school. Dion Peoples, you are always one to stay busy, you like exercise, and you're also a very compassionate listener for your classmates. Whenever anyone has something to talk about or they need support, you're always there to ask them questions and make sure they know you care. I also would like to take a moment to introduce our cabinet members and our school board. And I apologize for not doing that first. Ms. Terry Weems, our school board president. Mr. Zachary Smith. We appreciate you being here to celebrate with us. I'd like to introduce Dr. Delgado, our superintendent. I'd like to introduce Dr. Bobby Goodrum, whom I'm sure needs no introduction. Dr. Jackie McDougall, our Director of Student Services. Dr. Kelly Coffin, our Assistant Superintendent. Ms. Jennifer Kaminsky. Ms. Kathy Smith. And Ms. Diane Bauman. Without all of their devoted devotion to visions, we would not be where we are today. We appreciate all of their support and their willingness to continue to support and encourage our students. Thank you. And now Dr. Delgado, our superintendent, will give our commencement address.
Thank you. Good morning, everyone. Good morning to our Visions graduates, our scholars, staff, family, and friends. It is my pleasure to be one of many to congratulate you on your accomplishment this morning. As your superintendent, I couldn't be prouder that the Farmington Public Schools has the Visions Unlimited program, full of dedicated teachers and staff members who don't just care about you and your education, they love you. Let's pause for a second and talk about the title of your school. It's called Visions Unlimited. So what is a vision? A vision can be many things. Something you dream about, a wish you hope will come true, or a goal that you set for yourself. But what's most important about a vision is that you can see it. Sometimes you see it when you close your eyes and you think about what you want to accomplish. It's there right in your mind. Sometimes you see it when you dream about your future. Maybe when you're actually sleeping, or maybe daydreaming in class, although that never happens at Vision, especially with all the cardio drumming going on. But when you dream, you see that vision inside yourself. Here's what I sincerely wish for you. I'm sorry. And sometimes you see a vision when a teacher helps you think about how you apply what you've learned in school to a job after you finish. That's called a goal, and it's a vision coming to life. And when you know in your heart that all the work you've done throughout preschool, elementary, middle, high school, and visions was worth it, because now it is paying off, that's when you see your vision come true. The great news is that we get to see it come true with you. Well, what about the word unlimited? It's Visions Unlimited. What does that mean? Simply put, a limit is something that stops you. Think about a huge boulder in the middle of a road that you can't get past. That stops you. That limits you. Think about walking down the street and seeing those orange construction cones that mean the sidewalk is closed. Those stop you. Or think about taking a hike in a mountain and coming around the corner to face a grizzly bear. That would definitely stop you. But if something is unlimited, it means that you can't be stopped. Ever. Visions Unlimited is your school. The goal is to help give you the skills to live your life to the fullest, with purpose, dignity, and a way to contribute to your society. So here's what I sincerely wish for you. A life full of health, happiness, friendship, and a sense of accomplishment in whatever you choose to do. And I will simply say this, you are the coolest bunch of students I've had the pleasure of meeting. You have such talent, as we saw at the talent show and the Kickstart Art Gallery, and there's no way my wife and I could keep up with you on the dance floor at the gala. So on behalf of the Farmington Public School District, congratulations to Gabriella, Ashley, Jonathan, Bryce, Jacob, Michael, Wuju, and Dion. I'll miss you all, so please stay in touch and let us know how your visions are coming true. Thank you.
And now, Ms. Michelle Cramp will come up and have a performance. You're obviously not going to get through this morning without one technical glitch. We appreciate your patience. We've all practiced at visions many times. We need to be flexible and patient. This is just one more opportunity for us to practice that skill. Now that it's working, we just need to turn the volume up a little. Thank you for your patience. Now, Miss Michelle Graham.
you who have been at a number of Visions graduations as I have know that it's just not complete.
Google 5, a phone plan by Google. Save that on Samsung Galaxy S. With more.
from the Farmington Public Library.
Something told me not to say no, so I didn't say no. And so began our partnership with Visions. That day, when I did not say no, I thought we were giving the students an opportunity, but what I didn't realize is that they were giving us an opportunity. And so began story time, and just like we saw today, sometimes you have technical difficulty. Well, one of the communication boards wasn't working, and there were the little preschoolers sitting there patiently waiting, not complaining, not making any comments, not doing anything, just sitting there waiting until we got the communication board working. And I was in awe and amazed by that. And then I was a little annoyed because those preschoolers are never that generous with us. If I'm not showing the pictures just right, they let me know. But here they were, and I was like, this is truly amazing. And the parents and the children and the staff, they all loved the students coming. And I'm hoping that this fall they'll be able to come back. And another opportunity arises. I received a lovely note from a parent from one of the Vision students. The note card was beautiful. And then I saw that it was made by the students. And I was like, what? These students make cards? Do you sell them? How do you get them? Do people know about these? So many questions I had, and I thought, how can we get the word out? So began the sales at the library that happened twice a year in December and May. Each time, they bring new items that the kids have created. The students have so much talent. Just this past weekend, I was at the market, and I saw some new items, and I was buying cards, Move Over Hallmark, that's on Saturday, where they had that booth, and Megan pointed out, you know, Miss Maria, we make our own paper. They are rightfully proud of the work they create. Just recently, their artwork was displayed in the local art gallery, Kickstart. Think about that. Their artwork was displayed in an art gallery. What an honor and a privilege for their work to be shown, where people, you know, wait for years to get a showing. And it was amazing. So the next time their artwork is featured, stop in the Kickstart. The talent doesn't stop at art. Each year the students put on a talent show. As soon as I heard that, I had to go. And after I saw the first one, I let everyone know that they need to go to the talent show that the students put on because it's amazing. And now all I have to say now is Move Over Broadway. You can see it right here in Detroit, Farmington. One of my coworkers asked, can I start a book group with the Vision students? And of course I said, yes. It has been going strong, and I am so thankful that that started before COVID, because we were still able to continue doing it during COVID, because we were able to transition to it online. And the students loved it so much, they do it year round. So even when they're not in school, they still do the book group. And I know how much Ms. Rebecca loves that, and the students love that. And being able to do it during the pandemic meant a lot to us because we were still able to have that connection with the students. This year, the library became a work site. My hope is that the students learned a few new skills and got something out of the experience. I know on Monday, as in yesterday. My coworkers and I said, I sure did miss the students' revisions already. They were such a help. We had this big project going on, and other staff in other departments were saying, hey, do you need some volunteers to help? And I proudly got to say, nope, we got it, because our vision students were helping us out. And let me tell you, they did a better job than some of those other volunteers. And Alice was worried that we might not have anything for them next year. And I said, oh, don't you worry, Alice. We'll have something. Jonathan, who is graduating this year, was one of the students that came. And he was able to shelf read. I don't know if y'all know this, but Jonathan has an attention for detail like nobody I know. And he can shelf read better than a lot of adults. The other thing that we're going to miss about Jonathan is that he made us all so special. Each and every day. All these students make each and every one of us feel special. All during the last two very challenging years, with their teachers' help, they were able to meet academic daily life skills and provincial work skills goals. How is it even possible? Because they exemplify hope and learning. That's how. I recently saw a marquee that said something like, not taking a shot 100% of the time is missing an opportunity. Take the shot each and every time. If it doesn't work out, that doesn't mean you failed. But not taking the shot is failing. Graduating class, you take the opportunity each and every day. I am awed and amazed by you. You have the skills that cannot be taught. Perseverance, kindness, and the willingness to learn. Thank you for the opportunity you gave me and the library. Congratulations.
Thank you so much, Ms. Maria. We so appreciate those words. And I know the students love the library just as much as you love them coming to the library. Thank you. At this time, we're going to prepare for our video tribute for our students. I'd like to take this opportunity to ask the school board and our distinguished guests if they'd like to have a seat in the auditorium just so you're able to view this. I have tissue over here on the side. I need to have that.
is strong. Those who can face this world on their own. Who seem to get by on their own. Those who will never take the fall. We call them weak, who are unable to resist. The slightest chance that might exist. And for that forsake it all. They're so hell-bent on living, walking a wire, convinced it's not living if you stand outside the fire. Standing outside the fire. Standing outside the fire. Life is not tried, it is barely surviving. You're standing outside the fire.
Just gotta keep going.
enjoyed that as much as we did. And now, before we hand out our diplomas, I'd like to take a moment to introduce Dr. Bobbi Goodrum. I know the students adore her, and I know it wouldn't be a Visions graduation unless we heard from Dr. Goodrum.
Good morning, had to check. I don't know, never know if it's morning or afternoon. My goodness, every time we watch the videos, and I reflect upon the fact, like for Gabby, who I've known for 15 years, my entire time here at Farmington, I've been working with Gabby, and for the past 8 years, have had, and Jake, for the entire 15 years. And then for the past 8 years, Jonathan, and Wooju, and DJ, and Michael, and Bryce, and Ashley. I know as I walked in, I asked Wooju, I said, Wooju, how are we gonna run the kitchen now? Like, what are we gonna do? Like, what's gonna happen? Just the best. It kept everybody in mind who worked in the kitchen. And boy, Jonathan, we're still gonna need you to do those yearbook covers. Like, what are we going to do without these students? And DJ, I need Granny to raise her hand. All right, because when I saw you, he said, Granny here. I said, I cannot wait to meet her, sir, because I've heard so much about you, madam, through the times that we have worked with DJ and just everybody. I want you all to think about the video that you just saw and remember that these students are not only scholars, they are athletes, they are talented artists, they sing, they dance. These students do every single thing. And they will continue, if we provide them with what they need, they will continue to do every single thing that leads to them being happy and being productive and being full members of this world as they are and as they should be. I always feel like being principal of Visions was the most and has still been, even for my time as interim superintendent, has been my most important job in this district because it has been so important. Love you too, girl. It has been so important to just make sure that, and it wasn't hard, first of all, because one thing, the staff at Visions, Doreen and all of the staff at Visions, we always say, you know, we thank you all, parents and families, for entrusting you with your students. Know that the staff cares so much and are willing to do any and everything to ensure that your students have the best possible experience because we believe in each and every one of them and we know that each and every one of them is brilliant in their own way and has just a really bright future ahead of them. So again, to the class of 2022, you all know that I love you dearly. To the staff and faculty, everybody at Visions, I love you dearly. To every family member who works with these, like you give them to us for a short time. We know that they are yours for a lifetime, even though they're ours for a lifetime too, but you really, 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 really have them forever. We love you dearly because we could not do any of this if we did not do it all together, and everybody caring about these students, and these students knowing the power, the brilliance, the beauty that they have, helps them go out into this world and make it a better place. So congratulations to the class of 2022. I am so proud of you.
And now we'll Miss Gabriella Cruz. Mr. Jonathan Horton. Mr. Bryce Cobb.
Thank you.
Mr. Woo Joon-nam. Of course, all of our students will be there. Thank you very much for your attention today.